Hello, welcome to Santa Fe College Nursing Labs. Today I'm going to be demonstrating tracheostomy care. There are going to be two parts to this video. Part one is going to include the suctioning of a trach, and part two will include the changing of the inner cannula or washing of the inner cannula, including changing the dressing below the tracheostomy. So we need to make sure that we have the correct equipment in the room in order to do tracheostomy care and suctioning. So we have our workstation on wheels, which we use to check the order. We have the suction canister and suction machine. We also have our ambu bag, which is attached to an oxygen source. Any patient with a tracheostomy needs to have a new tracheostomy at bedside. It needs to have the new trach, including the obturator in place, so that in an event of an emergency where the current trach is dislodged, there is a new one that is the correct size right at bedside. I have gathered my supplies, checked my doctor's order, and now it's time to enter the room. Sanitize, wash my hands. Hello, Mrs. Jones, how are you doing today? So I'm gonna introduce myself to the patient. I'm gonna ask her to state her first and last name as well as her date of birth. I'm gonna double check her armband that she is the correct patient. I'm gonna explain to the patient what we are gonna do, and then I am gonna double check the room for all the necessary equipment. So Mrs. Johnson, I'm gonna go ahead and suction your trach, and I'm just gonna make sure I have all of the necessary equipment. So I'm checking, I have my ambu bag, which is attached to oxygen. I can go ahead and turn my oxygen on as well now. So I'm gonna remove the one tie on the trach tent in order to make it easier for myself to move later on with one hand. I can see that she has a new tracheostomy, including obturator at bedside. I'm gonna go ahead and check my suction machine and canister. For suctioning a tracheostomy, it's recommended that you are between 80 and 100 millimeters of mercury, which I am. Next, I need to raise the patient up to a height that is comfortable for me. When I do tracheostomy suctioning, I also need to raise the head of the bed and make sure that the patient is at a 45 degree angle. Okay. So before I suction the patient, I need to listen to the breath sounds. If you need a review listening to breath sounds, please watch the physical assessment video. Usually breath sounds are listened to under the gown. You do not want to listen over the gown, but for the purpose of the video, I'm going to be listening over the gown. Next, I'm going to move my supplies closer to the patient in order to start suctioning. I'm going to lower this rail so I do not hurt my back. The supplies that you need to do trach suctioning include sterile normal saline or sterile water, a sterile container in order to check your suction, sterile suction catheter, and then I have two pairs of sterile gloves. You always bring extra gloves in case you contaminate by accident. So the first thing I'm going to do to get my supplies ready is fill up my sterile container. I'm going to open the cap, put the cap upside down. When you're opening a new bottle of normal saline or sterile water, you want to make sure that the bottle is within date, that it has not expired. If you are the first person opening this bottle, you also want to label it with the date and time and your initials when you open it. Most hospital policies are after 24 hours, this bottle is considered non-sterile and has to be thrown out. I'm going to loosen my cap. The cap goes face up. When I hold my bottle, I want my palm on the label so that you avoid dripping any liquid onto the label. And I'm just gonna pour a little bit of normal saline or sterile water into my cup. I can then replace the cap. I'm then gonna wanna open up my suction catheter, maintaining sterility. I then need to put my sterile gloves on. I'm right-handed, so my right glove goes on first. I pick up, step back. I'm then going to put on my left glove. Step back from the table. Okay. My hands are at the moment still sterile, so I'm going to go ahead and pick up my sterile suction catheter. And I want to wrap this around my dominant hand, which for me is my right hand. I want to hold it in this position. I am now purposely going to contaminate my left hand. I have to reach for my suction tubing. Without touching my left and my right hand, I need to attach the suction catheter to the tubing. Okay. This hand and the end part of the suction catheter is now contaminated and not considered sterile. I'm going to go ahead and check to make sure my catheter and suction is working without touching the edges. I'm going to go ahead now and wrap the catheter back around my hand in order to maintain sterility. I have wrapped the catheter around my hand. I'm then going to go ahead and remove the mist collar. Before we suction, we need to hyperoxygenate the patient. You can do this a couple of different ways. If the patient is able to, you can ask them to take 2 to 3 deep breaths in. If the patient is ventilated, you can use the sigh mechanism. If the patient is not ventilated, you can also attach an ambu bag to oxygen, and when they breathe in, you can deflate the bag to help increase their inspiratory volume. So I'm going to go ahead and hyperoxygenate my patient. So take a deep breath in. Good. And another deep breath. And one more. Excellent. Now I'm going to go ahead and suction the patient. We are only suctioning as long as the trach. We do not put the suction catheter all the way down until it meets resistance. We do not want to damage the airway. When inserting the catheter, you do not have the suction on, only when withdrawing the catheter. The patient may cough as I'm withdrawing the catheter and suctioning. When you are withdrawing the suction catheter, you want to twist in order to get all the surfaces of the tracheostomy tube. So your patient may cough when you're suctioning. I'm going to go ahead and just clear my suction tubing. So depending on your patient, you may need to suction again or you may not suction. You can at this point double check breath sounds before you suction again, or when you first listen to them and they sounded really junky and you know you need a suction again, or you got a copious amount of fluid out, you would want to suction a second or third time. Since we are not going to suction again for this patient, I'm going to go ahead and replace my missed collar. So I'm going to disconnect my suction catheter from my suction tubing. I can then turn off my suction machine. My gloves cannot come off, and I can throw my catheter away. I want to make sure that I replace my trach tent appropriately, that it is nicely secured over the patient's trach. So that is the end of part one. Next up will be part two, where we will be cleaning the inner cannula and cleaning around the dressing site.